Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to talk about encountering branched R groups in our molecules, and this is going to bring up the idea of using parentheses to sort of compartmentalize parts of our names. So this slide starts off with a structure. This is a molecule we haven't seen it before, but we already know how to name this. This is an acarbon structure. It's going to be some kind of octane. And I've numbered the chain so that our methyl group comes off at the 3 position, gets as low a number of possible because it's an early branch point. And the name of this molecule is 3-methyloctane. Now let's make one little change to our molecule. We're going to put a chloro group on our molecule, and it's going to be off that methyl group. Now, how do we handle this? This is going to be still an octane. That's our longest chain. We're going to number from the same side, but this group is no longer a simple methyl group, and it's not a chloro group. It's actually a combination of the two. So in the 3 position, we have a complex group, and so we put in a parentheses, and this is a methyl group with a chlorine on it. We're going to call it a chloromethyl. So 3-chloromethyloctane. This octane has something in the 3 position. What's in the 3 position? Look to the very end of the parentheses. Our methyl group is in the 3 position, and oops, there's something on our methyl group. It's a chloro. So this is 3-chloromethyloctane. Now let's name the second structure. This is a 9-carbon chain. It's going to be a nonane. So it's a nonane. And in the nonane, on our nonane, we have in the 5 position some kind of 5-carbon chain. Now, as it turns out, when we count this, we're going to say in the 5 position, we have actually 3 carbons coming off. This is going to be a propyl substituent. However, our propyl substituent has an additional 2 carbons on it. And those 2 carbons, that ethyl group of those 2 carbons, comes off at the 1 position of our propyl. So here's where it gets a little messier. In the 5 position, we have a complex group. We have, coming off of our propyl chain, an ethyl group. And that ethyl is attached to the 1 position of the propyl chain. So it's a 1-ethyl propyl nonane. So what do we have? We have a nonane. That nonane has something in the 5 position. What's in the 5 position? Go to the end of the parentheses. It's our propyl group. But our propyl group itself has something coming off of it. It has, in the 1 position, an ethyl group. So using parentheses, we can give numbering for different groups. So this number 1 refers to the propyl chain, not the nonane. And the parentheses let us separate these ideas. Now let's go to the last structure. Again, this is going to be a nonane. Still has 9 contiguous carbons in a chain, and it's just going to be slightly different. What we've done is we've added a bromine group. So here again is our propyl group coming off of our nonane chain, and off of the propyl we have an ethyl group in position 1, and we've added a bromo group in position 2. So this is simply 5 complex group. Now we have a bromo and ethyl. The bromo comes first alphabetically, so it's 2 bromo, and that 2 refers to the ethyl chain, I'm sorry, the propyl chain, then the ethyl group, which comes off at the 1 position of our propyl chain, 1 ethyl, all on our propyl chain, and this whole thing sits in the 5 position of our nonane. So this is how we use parentheses. We use it to break up our name so that we can refer to other positions. So this propyl chain has 2 groups on it, 1 in the 2 position, a bromo, 1 in the 1 position, an ethyl. And then the 5 position refers to where its entire chain is on the nonane. So that's how we use parentheses to incorporate more complex branched R groups into our molecules.